I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming.
I'm back where I belong. Yeah, I never felt so strong. Yeah, I'm back. I'm feeling like there's nothing I can't try. And if you with me, put your hands high.
Put your hands high. You haven't lost a life before. Hey, this one's
if
for you.
With me, put your hands high.
Your dreams are filled. You're rocking with the best.
Hey,
I'll be on soon.
I'm coming home. I'm coming home.
Hey, what's up? It's your boy Joe, the premiere of the 2012 Baltimore Ravens mock draft is finally here. It is Thursday, March 1st, 2012. Mock draft rounds 1 and 2 for the Baltimore Ravens is finally out. So, you know, I've been giving this a lot of thought over the past couple weeks and really kind of heated up after the combine. There will be a couple more before the actual draft on April 26th, and around the week of April 26th, the last one will come out for the Baltimore Ravens. Not sure if I'm going to do an actual NFL mock draft, but right now this is the Ravens round 1 and 2. And the reason I do rounds 1 and 2 and not 3, 4, 5, 6 is because then it gets a little bit more complicated. You got to give it a lot more thought. But it's really, you know, for me coming together on these first two rounds, in my general opinion, I mean, there's a lot of players out there that seem to be kind of trying to form a marriage with Baltimore, the same as Baltimore trying to kind of form a marriage with them. And all the way out there's guys out there that we may not even know of, positions we might not even think we need that end up being our first round pick, the 29th pick overall. So if you're ready, I'm ready. Let's go. With the 29th pick in the 2012 NFL Draft, the Baltimore Ravens select Hill, wide receiver, Georgia Tech. Ravens been eyeing this young man for quite some time. Their eyes really lit up at the combine. So did mine. So did a lot of fans. Lying in the shadows. In my opinion, a lot of teams will overlook this young man over a Jeffrey, Reuben, Floyd, etc., etc. Overlook him. He can wait to the second or third. In my opinion, he's worth a first-round pick. So much unexplored talent. Now, Georgia Tech ain't all about the passing game, so his numbers ain't big. But you bring him into a team like Baltimore, you got the mix of the run, but then you got a strong-arm quarterback with Flacco. You got weapons he can learn from, a young Torrey Smith, a Bolden, and all receiving core. You pair him up, and all that unexplored talent comes out. This guy can be a deep threat, a big target down the field, and he's fast. He's super fast. Blowing past the corners, blowing past the defenders. And I don't think that was a combine or a college fluke. This is real. He's got some incredible hands. Running down the field, reaching up and grabbing these balls, sometimes with one hand, bringing them in. The flexibility, reaching out, grabbing the ball, and just his speed is absolutely amazing. He's got some good blocking skills, too. Again, you hear some people say he's not a real deep threat, you know, nowhere near a deep threat, and I disagree. I think you put him on the field with a quarterback that may not throw the ball 99% of the time, but has the ability to throw downfield deep. This young man's going to come into big play. You can't go to Smith, can't go to Bolden. Well, you go to Stephon Hill, wide receiver, Georgia Tech. And I think there's going to be a marriage real soon forming between these two football teams. Baltimore is looking for another receiver to pair up with Torrey Smith, this veteran receiving core, and veteran Joe Flacco to make Joe Flacco, in my opinion, a Pro Bowl quarterback to get us to the next level. And I'm not saying we get Stephon Hill and we go to the Super Bowl next year. In my opinion, this guy can make an immediate impact on that football field, going downfield, making some incredible grabs, some incredible catches in the end zone, in the red zone. He always seems to want to extend the play. Can be a nightmare on that field. It's yet to be proven, but I believe Baltimore takes the gamble at pick 29. They don't let him slide. I can't sit here and say, this is your next Hall of Fame wide receiver, your next Pro Bowl wide receiver. I can't sit here and say that, you know, it's going to be a matchup like a Wayne, Breeze to a Colston, you know, Ryan to a White. Can't sit there and say that. But a Flacco to Hill, I like that combination. I think Baltimore does as well. So that's pick 29. But again, things could change. We'll just have to wait and see. Second round, the Baltimore Ravens select Chandler Jones, defensive end, Syracuse. Not a Dante Hightower, not a Vontaze Buffet. Chandler Jones, defensive end, Syracuse. And y'all know Arthur Jones. You're going to get to know Chandler Jones real fast. A very talented young football player. Raw, but raw talent. You bring him onto a team. Baltimore takes the gamble. You bring him on a team with people like young Paul Kruger, Ray Lewis, Terrell Suggs, Halugnata. A great Ravens defense. You can really mold that raw talent into something pretty damn good. Now, this guy may not be hard hitter. You know, some amazing pass rushing skills. You know, you got questions about turning corners, and he may not hit you like a freight train, but he has those hand skills to drag you and pull you down. Got kind of that initial quickness off the burst. He's going to get in your face real fast, kind of stop the quarterback before he gets, you know, a chance to get going. Really interfere with the run game. So run game's going one way, he's going to make it go another way. He might even bring you down with those incredible hand skills he got. Again, not the biggest guy in the world. I mean, he can hurt you on that bull rush, but you know, he's not going to hit you like a perfect wood. But I'm telling you, Ravens take a gamble. Get this young man, and it really pays off for him. He's got some incredible skills. You know, the run defense, the pass defense, it needs work. But really, you put him on a team, and it's just that close to being molded into something good. And that's not just me speaking. That's a lot of the experts' opinions. He fits on the right team, on the right scheme. You put him in with the right players, and he can mold into something pretty damn good. He's very young and physical football player at defensive end. So that's my pick at round two. Now you're wondering, Joe, where's round three, four, five? Six, etc., etc. That'll be coming up in my final mock draft of all rounds for the Baltimore Ravens. But in the meantime, we'll continue to do these mock drafts one at a time. They may change, they may not. They're consistently moving around because I'm consistently looking at other prospects and seeing any kind of marriage or any kind of molding that's being formed. I mean, you gotta understand that if a team really likes a football player, the mold can happen earlier. It can happen, you know, 6 minutes before the draft. You just never know. So, I'm your boy Joe. Until next time, this has been your premiere of rounds 1 and 2 for the Baltimore Ravens mock draft. A little quick wrap up. But enjoy, mold it over. Tell me what you think. Do you like Stephon Hill at number 1? Pick 29 in the second round, Chandler Jones out of Syracuse. What do you like? Maybe you want somebody else. Maybe you don't. Maybe you like it. Maybe you don't. Until next time, peace out. Go Ravens. Ravens Nation, baby. 247, repping at RRG.